And the war is only 4 days away at Bash of the Beach. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring into this time a man who was one of the toughest ever to compete on the gridiron in the National Football League, and truly one of the toughest ever to get into a squared circle, the one and only Steve Mongo McMichael.
He's right about that. One tough customer.
Well, considering that he was Mike Ditka's favorite player, that says volumes right there.
Did you see Ditka sing the national anthem the other day at Wrigley Field? Yes. He yelled it.
Yes.
What do you think him and Mongo ever said to each other?
Steve McMichael, and I know I speak on many of the fans, it's great to see you back in action. Last week on this program, a very special up-close interview talked about your career in the NFL, some very complimentary words from head coach Mike Ditka. Then you went on to close out the interview with a message to Arn Anderson concerning the Four Horsemen.
That's right, Tony. I'm out here to talk about Four Horsemen business, especially to Arn Anderson. Now, you've known him longer than I have, Tony, but I've looked in that man's eye. I've seen the fire that burns there. I've looked in his soul. And for everybody that needs a refresher course to know who this man really is, I've come up with a little package. Roll that tape, please.
Hey, let's take a look at it right now.
Gene Oakland, whether you hate me, whether you love me, whether you respect me or you don't respect me, the one thing I've always given everybody is I've always called a spade a spade. I've either loved with a passion or I've hated with a passion and with a vengeance. And everybody has had a family member at one time or the other that was messing up. And you had to grab them and you had to shake them because words no longer mattered. Well, Ric Flair, I've been back here. My stomach has been in knots. My heart's been pounding out of my chest, and I wouldn't be telling the truth if I didn't tell you I'm a nervous wreck because I got to trade fists with somebody that I love more than God itself. You understand? You've been a brother to me when I didn't have one. Now I got to go trade fists with you. But it's something that's got to happen because when I get up in the morning and look in that mirror, I got to answer to me. And if you don't stand up in this world, all a man can do is stand up and live by his word, right or wrong. Tonight, I give Asheville, I give the world, and I give you, Ric Flair, my word on this. I'm going to give you all I got as a man, and win, lose, or draw, trust me, I'm going to respect myself in the morning, and you're going to respect me.
Well, that was Arn Anderson in a recent fall brawl right before a match that really put him, I feel, right to the top of the list of the Four Horsemen.
Well, for everybody that doesn't know, he beat the 13-time world champion that night, Ric Flair. He stepped up beside the 13-time world champion. He wasn't no longer in the shadow of the Four Horsemen as the enforcer. He became the driving force behind the Four Horsemen, my friend. That's what we need. I want you to think about this, Arn Anderson. I thought that fire that burned in me was gone when I was through playing football. But brother, it can burn again. Here I am walking down this aisle in wrestling, and I feel the adrenaline. Just think about it, baby. That's all I want you to do.
All right. Well, fans, Steve Mongo McMichael with a plea to Arn Anderson. Now let's take a very special ringside look at the upcoming Something About Mary comedy hit coming your way in theaters everywhere.